Let's begin with a simple question. How can you have confidence in your patient results? Regular quality control testing confirms the precision of your test systems and is the foremost way to provide confidence that your patient results are correct. Regulations and standards across the world have specific quality control requirements or guidelines. Meeting applicable requirements is the responsibility of every laboratory. Let's take a look at a few of the standards from around the world. The International Organization for Standardization created an international standard, ISO 15189. I recommend that you pause the video and review the excerpts if you're not familiar with the standards. For Australian laboratories, the National Association of Testing Authorities created AS 4633. The College of American Pathologists created the Chemistry and Toxicology Accreditation Checklist for labs in the U.S. Both the Quality Council of India and the National Accreditation Board for Testing and Calibration Laboratories have created documents for Indian laboratories. Finally, U.S. laboratories are also governed by the Clinical Laboratory Improvement Amendments. The different worldwide standards might leave some laboratories looking for a starting point. Start by running a quality control before running patient samples. Determine if the control value is acceptable. If it is, you can report reliable patient results. If it isn't, troubleshoot, resolve the issue, and repeat the test. As you can see, adding regular quality control testing to your processes isn't difficult. However, it is critical because an external proficiency program is not enough. While external proficiency programs also play an essential role in assuring quality, they are not enough when used alone. EQA schemes typically involve testing unknown samples on a monthly or bi-weekly basis and can only provide information about the testing performed on that particular assay run on that particular day. What about the tests that are run in between EQA samples? How can the laboratory be sure of these patient test results? Let's look at 5 steps to implement daily quality control in your laboratory. Step 1 is calculating the mean. The mean, or average, provides the best estimate of the analyte's true value for a specific level of control. I encourage you to take a look at our video for calculating the mean if you need more information. The next step is to calculate the standard deviation. The standard deviation quantifies how close numerical values are in relation to each other and is used to assess the precision of the test system. We also have a video that covers standard deviation. Using the mean and standard deviation, the laboratory can establish decision limits. These limits are used to define what is considered an acceptable control result. Decision limits are established at plus or minus 1S, 2S, and 3S from the mean. Using the mean and the plus or minus 3S range, a Levy-Jennings chart is created for each test and each level of control. Daily QC data is plotted on this chart, which allows the laboratory to monitor the precision of their test procedures. Finally, evaluate the QC data. When an analytical process is in control, the QC data will fall in a distribution with approximately 99.7% of the results falling within the plus or minus 3S limits. QC results that are outside the 3S limits are generally considered out of control, and the run should be rejected. QC data greater than 2S but within the 3S limit does not necessarily indicate that the run must be rejected, as approximately 4% of the valid data points will fall between 2S and 3S. As you can see, the 5 steps to implement daily quality control in your laboratory are not that complicated. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.